These are the best to-do list apps of 2024. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode and I've rounded up the top 5 to-do list apps of 2024, tried and tested just for you. Let's go. All right, some of these apps are free and some of these apps are paid, but up first is Akiflow. Think of Akiflow like your ultimate time blocking tool. Akiflow allows you to consolidate all of your tools and apps into one place. So you can bring in tasks from Gmail, Trello, Google Meet, Google Calendar, Notion, Asana, Todoist, and more. This is really handy if you or your team uses more than one tool. You can now bring in those individual tasks and take care of them in one central place. Akiflow easily allows for calendar time blocking, you can share your availability, and you can set daily rituals to help make your day planning easier. Plus, they have a built-in focus mode to help you focus on the task at hand. Now, all of this doesn't come cheap. Akiflow has a free trial, but after that, it's $19 a month, which is pretty steep. All right, we're moving on to one of my favorite to-do list apps, Google Tasks. I've talked about Google Tasks a lot before, so if you want more than just a quick intro here, I've linked to those videos here or in the description below. If you live in Gmail and Google Workspace like I do, then look no further than Google Tasks. It's a free, simplistic task manager that's found in your suite of Google apps. So there's a mobile app for Google Tasks, but there's no dedicated web app. Instead, Tasks is found within your Google apps, in the side panel on the right-hand side of your Gmail or Drive or Calendar. It's linked to your Google account. You can easily create lists and add and organize tasks, and then these lists and tasks will be synced across web and mobile. Plus, if you have more than one Google account, you can easily toggle between them in the Google Tasks mobile app. All right, up next on my list of top to-do list apps is Microsoft To Do. This is a classic app that is so loved by its user base. Microsoft bought Wunderlist back in 2015 and then built out Microsoft To Do as a replacement app. So it doesn't have all the bells and whistles that Wunderlist had. It's really simple to use. If you have a Microsoft account, you can sync it up with your other Microsoft apps. With Microsoft To Do, you can change themes, you can create your to-do lists, share those lists with others, and create recurring tasks. The best part, you know it's coming, Microsoft To Do is also completely free. All right, next on the list is TickTick. I love TickTick so much that I've talked about it a couple times before, so I've got those videos linked for you in the description as well. TickTick is a powerful yet easy to use task manager. It works across platforms so you can stay organized from mobile to web. You can also share your tasks with others. You can set reminders as well, or you can use the Pomodoro technique within TickTick to stay focused and productive. Plus, it's got an integrated calendar view. And guess what? TickTick is completely free, with a paid option, of course. And if you've made it this far and you're liking this video, please remember to give it a like and subscribe to my channel for more content just like this. And with that, we head back to our list. And I would not be able to put together a to-do list app list without mentioning Todoist. This is a solid one. Todoist remains one of the best rated to-do list apps on the market for a number of reasons. It has a great user interface and it's easy to use and it works offline. Todoist is great for personal use or even small companies. You can quickly add tasks, recurring due dates, and create sections and subtasks. Plus, you can also set priority levels for those tasks, highlighting the most important ones you want to get through in a day. You can delegate tasks to team members as well as customize your own task views through different themes and different boards. Of course, Todoist connects with your email and calendars as well. Now, there is a free version where you can create up to 5 projects and have 5 collaborators per project. But you don't get custom themes or backups with that. It's a good place to start though, so you can get an idea if you like the UI and the overall function of the app. The pricing tiers do go up from there. They're between $4 and $6 per month for pro and business users, which is really affordable for what you get with Todoist. So those are my picks for the best to-do list apps of 2024. What are your favorites and why? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I wanna know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more content just like this. Thanks for watching. See you next time.